Dino, thank you very, very much for joining us. I know it's a difficult time. I know it's a tough period for everybody in the world right now, but you're obviously in the epicenter of everything over in China. How has it been for you? I mean, you're in, I think, was it, say, day six now of quarantine. How are you coping?
No, for me, so far so good. It's been the sixth day, but for me, as I said before, I'm used to this life, so it's not much of a hassle for me, you know. Unlike other people who are already complaining for this 21 days that the state president has, you know, declared to the country. So yeah, I cannot complain that much. I'm just, you know, self-introspective with myself as I do usually. But this for me is not it's an easy thing for me.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, being over in China, I mean, you've got people coming to t check your temperature, you're in quarantine, imposed, so obviously, since your arrival back in the country. How has it been like in terms of when you landed? Like when you landed in China, what is the sort of the situation when you get there?
You know, the thing is, it was a bit scary when I arrived at the airport because the airline that I used before, it was the first time I've been in an airline, Air China. As I said, I've used Air China domestically when we're playing games in China. So internationally, it was the first time I used the Air China Airlines. So when I landed in Shenzhen, I was really amazed how the Chinese have been set up everything to contain this virus. Normally, what they do is that when you go out of the flight, you go inside the bus. Before you enter into the terminals inside the airport, they set up like containers that you go through. They, you know, you go through questionnaires that they ask you normally, and you go through tests. So let's say, for example, they test you positive and you already left the airport, or you have connected to your next destination and it's domestically around China. What made me so impressed with this is that they will check you because on the question on the form that you fill in, you need to write where will you be staying for the duration of your time in China. If you work here, you need to write your residence number, stuff like that. So they will check you and they will find you. Not necessarily you did something wrong. They will check and find you. When they find you, they will put you in a separate quarantine with everyone that they think that has been in contact with someone who has the virus. So that's how Chinese have contained this thing. You know, I tell you now, everyone is back to normal. Everyone is back at trainings at work. Banks are working. Not mainly there's no virus in China because everyone who's tested positive, they've contained it. They've put them aside. They've isolated everyone into hotels or, you know, like some kind of camps where they set up everything for people who tested positive so they can minimize, you know, this virus as much as possible, you know. So that's one of the things that made me to really be astonished with how Chinese they've taken the route of containing this virus.
And obviously, how difficult was it for you? You know, you've left your family in South Africa. We're on a 21-day lockdown here. How difficult was it for you to take that decision and leave the family over this side?
Well, you know, for me, you know, the older you get, the more you want to be close with your family, the more time, the more your kids grow up, the more they, you know, realize that, you know, they want to spend time with you. So for me, it was not an easy thing. You know, I thought to myself, it was a blessing in disguise, this thing happened so I can spend more time with my family. But I was, you know, trying to boycott the decision that the club said I must come back because, you know, it was not safe. But from everything, the information I got and how the club has reassured everything that, you know, China is one of the safest countries now to be in across the world. So I said to myself, you know, why not? But my family, they just gave me a decision that, look, you have responsibilities. And, you know, the club has delayed payments for the past 2 months. So you have responsibilities that you need to look for and to, you know, before you take any drastic measures. Don't take decision because of how you're feeling, because you're angry and you're feeling otherwise, because these people, they didn't, you know, listen to you or trying to put themselves in your shoes that they said you must come back to China, or else you could have stayed back in South Africa with your family. But also, they're looking at their best interest. So then they said, look, Dino, now, because yesterday they've announced that on the 28th of March, all foreigners, they'll be banned to come inside the country. So all foreign players that play in China, they are arriving today or later this weekend, because also I think everything is in place for the league to be getting underway.
Have they given you a date in terms of when things can get back underway with the league?
The league the announcement was made that there's a possibility that the league's going to start on the 18th of April, but you know there's the dialogue that's been sent between the CFA and the FIFA, because a lot of leagues have been postponed, others are suspended until further notice. So from us, you know, the Chinese CFA, they've made all the necessary tests for all the players in the league, from the Liga 1 to the Super League, to, you know, submit to FIFA that, look, this is what we have, and we have contained the virus. Everyone who's roaming the streets, or who's working, or who's back at work now, they're negative. So what we want to do is we want to start the league, to get the league underway, but to be, you know, put everything, the health of other people and the players in good measures, that we're going to play behind closed doors.
Yeah.
We need to start the league, but they're still waiting for the response from FIFA. So
hopefully
we wait to that, maybe before the 10th or the 12th of April, we'll know the decision when the league is going to commence.
Yeah. And just from a personal perspective, obviously, what are you doing at the minute? You know, you're obviously not allowed to train. You're not allowed to do any of that stuff with the club. What are you doing at home to make sure you stay in shape?
Yeah, and then since Monday, because I arrived Saturday morning, so I had 2 days to recover my body because traveling was hectic towards me. So I have my own things in my room that I keep myself fit. You know, I use my medicine ball, my mat, my elastics. I have 3 elastics and I've got 10 kg weight. So for me, it's not one of the best trainings that you can, you can do as a sport, as an athlete, but you know, you don't just want to sit for 14 days not doing nothing.
Yeah.
At least, you know, you need to keep active. So I'm doing my sessions every day in the morning and in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So I think after we have this conversation, I'm going to start with my session.
Excellent.
So far, so good. I just had a 3 months pre-season, so it's not like I'm unfit or my body's in the lowest of shapes.
Yeah.
So yeah, man.
Perfect. And just before I let you go, do you have a message for South Africa in this, you know, difficult period?
Look, for me, I'm not going to say much, but I just want to tell South Africans that, look, I know it's difficult for South African people to, you know, to cope with the decision that the state president has taken, that you need to be indoors for 21 days. But I'm just saying that, you know, it's really difficult for me to be close to Chinese players in Turkey when I saw them since January. I was with them in Thailand, where they were telling me, only they were sharing their thoughts that, look, since January until now, like I think until 2 weeks ago, their families have been, you know, in quarantine for the past 2.5 months, 3 months. So if South Africans need this thing to pass smoothly and to finish, as the president has said, for 21 days, we need to work together, because alone we cannot do anything. Please, South African people, listen. This thing is serious. Let's take it serious. It can be worse if we're not going to take responsibility of actions or acting against what the president has taken, you know? So for me, that this 21 days, it will pass. It's only 2.5 weeks that we need to stay indoors. It's not easy, but if we're going to be irresponsible, it's going to be from 21 days to 3 months, and it's going to be like hell.
Yeah. No, that's, I completely agree, mate. But Dino, thank you so much for your time. Stay safe over there. Make sure you keep doing what you're doing, and hopefully we can see you banging some goals in the not so distant future.
Thanks, mate. Thanks for the call.
Cheers, brother.